tough for me because, you know, I have great memories with Olympiacos. I had many friends here. You know, I love the city.
It was tough, but, you know, it was maybe the right time, right moment for me to, you know, to go to another team, to step forward. And then CSKA, I mean, complete package from CSKA was amazing for me. And, you know, I'm really looking forward to play for them. And, you know, I'm excited what will happen next season.
You came with dreams to Olympiacos from Partizan. Okay, if we exclude that you didn't win the EuroLeague, did you achieve the dreams that you had?
Yeah, I mean, the main goal was to achieve to win the EuroLeague, and you know, that was my main target when I came to Olympiacos. Unfortunately, I didn't achieve it. I had the experience to play on Final Four. It was for me one of the best things that could happen for me in my life, and you know. Besides that, you know, I have all the other things, you know, it was good for me, you know, I could win more titles in the Greek League, but, you know, I'm not regretting anything, you know, and, you know, maybe one day I will have chance to achieve them again with this team.
Okay, now that you will move to CSKA, are you going to miss the games between Olympiacos and Panathinaikos?
Yeah, for sure. For sure I'm going to miss those games because I really love them, and it was really difficult for me this year when I couldn't play in CEF against them. But, you know, I will have great memories from those games, and, you know, like I said, maybe one day I will play those games again.
Last summer, CSKA made an offer to you, but you stayed to Olympiacos because the team denied the proposal of the Russian team. If you were the owner of Olympiacos, would you sell Milutinov last summer?
First of all, I'm not the owner, so I don't know what to answer. Okay, it was decision of them. So you know, yeah, I fully respect it because I know what I signed when I signed the contract. So you know, the contract was the main thing. You know, I'm professional, and I, you know. If my president say no, you know, I fully respected their decision. You know, I didn't. If they didn't want to sell me, you know, I will do my things professional, and I will stay in Athens. And you know, I really tried last season to try to do my best last season, and you know, try to help the team as much as I could. You know, it was their decision last summer, and you know, I fully respected it. You know, and I tried to do my job.
What happened with the NBA dream and the Spurs?
You know, I'm not looking forward anymore right now because, you know, to the NBA, because right now my mind is only to CSKA. And, you know, if one day again, you know, I have a chance to play in NBA, of course I would like to be there just to see how it is. But I'm not crazy anymore about it like I was when I was younger. And, you know, my goal is now only to try to win EuroLeague with CSKA, and you know, my mind is only with them.
Now you will work with another Greek coach. You work with Sferopoulos, with Bartzokas for a few months, and now with Coach Itoudis.
Yeah, I mean, I only heard
Greek
only...
Greek coaches are
yes,
pretty great in
they're
Europe.
Great, they're great, and you know, I hear only good things about him, and you know, what I could see, he's an amazing coach. And
Did you talk with him?
Yes, of course I talked to him, and you know, I'm really excited to be part of his team and to learn more from him because, you know, he's one of the best in EuroLeague right now.
You played 5 years with Pridesis, now you're going to play with Angelia. Pretty similar power forwards.
Yeah.
You played with Spanoulis, now you will play with Mike James. Okay, he's a little bit more...
Different
for the
style.
Instinct.
Yeah, different style. Yeah, I mean, I'm lucky that I have a chance to play with Spanoulis and Pridesis. You know, legends, and you know, amazing players and amazing person. You know, I learned a lot of things from them, and you know, now I will work. You know, I will play with other guys that are also one of the best right now in EuroLeague. You know, and you know, I'm happy and I'm honored that I had a chance to play with the guys in Olympiacos, and you know, I'm also happy and looking forward what will happen now in CSKA because you know. I can say that I'm blessed to have a chance to play with all of them.
What is the most important advice that Spanoulis and Pridis gave you throughout these years? That you, it is your guide now.
Yeah, to work as much as hard as I can right now when I'm young, and to not have any regrets when I get older.
Okay, tell me a few words about Angelopoulos brothers, because at your first years at Olympiacos everything was working okay. A couple of years ago they had some financial problems, so you saw them in the good way and in their difficult way. Tell me your opinion about them.
Yeah, I only have good things to say about them, because first of all, they bring young kid from Partizan, who is not, he's nowhere on the map, they trust in him, they help him grow as a person and as a player, they believed in me, and it's rare something like this to find in the world right now, and they were really good with me, they were, with whatever we talk, they did it, I think from both sides we were honest to each other, so I only have good things to say about them, and I think we have great relationship.
Do you like the idea that Diamandidis and Alvertis are running the front office of Panathinaikos?
Honestly, I do. They are legends for them. From what I can see, that Panathinaikos is a little bit in difficult position right now, and I believe those legends, will help them, to be on the good way. Because I believe for Greek basketball, it's good to have Panathinaikos and Olympiakos, and it's good to have both teams, because it's better also for the fans, for the people, for everybody. It's good to have good Panathinaikos and good Olympiakos, not only good one team.
Do you think that Olympiakos will go back to the basket league?
I mean,
it's not your decision.
I believe it's better for the players to have more games. This is what I believe, because I believe all the players like to play the games, and players, I believe, love more to play the games than to practice. So if you look from that side, I believe it's better maybe to play just so players can play, so everybody, maybe some players who doesn't play in EuroLeague, so they can have a chance to play more in the Greek league. From that point of view, I think it's good to play also Greek league.
We don't know what will happen to the future, but you mentioned twice that you might come back to Olympiakos, and it doesn't hear to my ears like a cliche. It seems like you give 1% someday to come back.
You never know what will happen in the future. I don't want to say, hey, I will come for sure, because I don't know what the future will bring, But, from this point, right now, because I know what kind of memories I have here, I know what I've been through, I know how much I love everything in Greece. So, I want to leave this as a possibility that one day to come, because I would honestly like to come back one day to play here, because I had a great moments here and had a great time, and everything was perfect for me here.
Okay, last question. Imagine at the EuroLeague final, CSKA against Olympiakos. Hard.
Hard, but CSKA now.
But CSKA now.